morning, my brothers and sisters, the Manchester Lay Workers Federation Personal Ministry Department wants to welcome you to our morning devotion entitled Lord in the Morning.
Let us pray to begin our worship. Father in heaven, as we come to you this morning, we pray, Lord, that our worship will be accepted. Accept our worship, accept our praise, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.
Our opening hymn is hymn number 39, Lord in the
devotion comes to us from the book of Matthew chapter 6 verses 33 and 34. The Bible reads, "But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Take therefore no thought for the morrow, for the morrow shall take thought for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof."
My task this afternoon is to pray for the churches in Manchester. We have 61 congregations, 16 pastoral fields, and I'm going to cover the entire parish at this time. Thanks to the Lay Workers Federation for this initiative, prayer focus, and encourage the team to keep the fire burning. I'm going to be reading a passage and a quote, Psalm 9, verse 9 and 10. Psalm 9, "The Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble. And they that know thy name will put their trust in thee. For thou, Lord, hast not forsaken them that seek thee. Sing praises to the Lord, which dwelleth in Zion." Amen. "That I may know them," page 270 says, "an earnest prayer offered from a contrite heart by one who desires to do the Master's will is of more value in God's sight than is eloquence of speech." Let us pray. Oh Heavenly Father, it is a privilege for us to be able to call upon your name, because you are worthy to be praised. You're our God. You're always there for your people. We can call on you at any time. And so, Lord, this afternoon I come to you on behalf of your people. Lord, it's not a simple task. It's a privilege. And so as this ordinary lump of clay stand in the gap on behalf of your people, I pray, Lord, that you will forgive me of my sins and cleanse me from all unrighteousness, Lord, that the prayers will ascend beyond this roof. In the quietness of this afternoon here at work, Lord, I pray for your people in a marked way. Forgive me, Lord, of my sins and cleanse me from all unrighteousness. Take charge now, I pray. Look down on your people at this very moment, from the four corners, from Octin Bedi to Poros to Mars Hill to Harry Watch. Lord, I place all the congregations into your hands at this time. I pray, Lord, in a very special way that you will be with every single member. Right now, there are some who are hurting badly, physically, spiritually. Some are unemployed at this time. Some are finding it very hard to cover their different expenses and to even deal with the daily meals. Some are not able to go to doctor, maybe afraid, maybe not be able to find a doctor bill, especially with this COVID-19 pandemic upon us. Lord, in a very special way, come by here and assure your people that you're the same God yesterday and the same God today, and you'll be the same tomorrow, lest we forget. Lord, I place the leadership of your church into your hands. In Manchester, I place all the pastors and the elders as they give leadership to the congregations. We know some of them are going the extra mile at this time to ensure that the needs, basic needs of your people are being met, and we give thanks. Lord, I pray that every single member will see the importance of their task at this time, and that is to ensure that they are part of the church, because the church is not so much the building. Yes, we want to congregate in the building, but the church is the people. We are the people. Buildings will be closed, but the church must remain open. I pray, Lord, that your people will not be neglected at this time, and at the same time, they will not neglect in terms of calling upon your name. Spend time in the Word, spend time in their quarterlies, spend time singing songs, because in a little while, we are going home. Take charge of your people once more, Lord. We know, Lord, that this is a difficult time. We are hurting, we are worried. But while we are worried, Lord, let us not be afraid of the terror by day. We pray, O Lord, that we will look to you, because you know our heart's desire. We can use this difficult time to get closer to you and closer to each other. We thank you, Lord, for hearing and answering our prayers. Touch your people once more. Touch the entire Federation, team members at large, led by the President, Stalicia Mitchell. God, touch the team. Touch Pastor McLean as he gives leadership, oh God, from the conference level. We know, Lord, that this time will make all of us the two things, one or the other, closer to you or a further away from you. I pray, Lord, that every single member of your church in this parish and beyond will be closer drawn to you, Lord. We look to you and we tell you thanks, both now and forever. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
The person who will be doing our devotional charge this morning is a vice president in the Manchester Lay Workers Federation. She is a Justice of the Peace. She is an elder of the Poor Seventh-day Adventist Church. Her name is Sister Odette Wright, one who is passionate about the gospel ministry and seeks to ensure that individuals both far and wide within the parish of Manchester, and more so the Central Jamaica Conference, is brought to the foot of the cross. We're happy for her ministry. But just before Sister Odette Wright brings us the charge this morning, our meditation song will come to us from Brother Claude Edwards.
Stand. quietness and the stillness of the morning. We should deem it a great privilege and joy as children of God to have a deep spiritual connection with Him. This is the only way for us to live a real and authentic life. When we wait upon the Lord, He shall renew our strength. We shall mount up with wings as eagles. We shall run and not be weary, and we shall walk and not faint. Isaiah 40:31. When we are connected to God, we will overcome temptations such as evil thinking. We will have a spirit of forgiveness and mercy. We will walk away from bickering, malice, anger, hate, and self-praise. We will help others to minister to others who are low in spirit, who are in need of food, a warm embrace, and words of comfort and cheer. When we evaluate the gravity of the pandemic around us in Jamaica and other countries, we recognized that tomorrow is not promised to any one of us. Therefore, we must anchor ourselves in the Lord and live within the 24 hours as if it is our last. Yesterday's meal will not suffice for today's daily portions, so we must eat from the word of the Lord to maintain spiritual stamina. Satan is seeking whom he may devour, and the only way to withstand the devil's snares is to abide under the shadow of the Almighty. We must thirst after righteousness. We must stay connected to Christ 24/7. We must meet the Savior at the well every single morning and drink. Christ told the woman at the well, "Whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life." It was a Savior's lifestyle to spend quality hours with his Father early in the mornings. He prayed for renewed strength. He interceded on the behalf of man and thus was able to stay connected to heaven. He knew his Father's will. Therefore, he was able to overcome the devil, evil angels, and evil men that were always after him. Satan will never leave us alone. But guess what? We have someone who can fight our battles. We cannot fight the devil on our own and win. And therefore, we must have the Savior with us at all times. For our faith at best is weak, according to the songwriter. God can whisper words of comfort that no other voice can speak. We must have the Savior with us in the onward march of life. Through the tempest and the sunshine, through the battle and the strife. Sister White embraces the same sentiment when she said, "We must remember we are co-workers with Christ. When we labor and when we engage in the labor, we should guard the mind. We should keep it stayed upon God. Remember, every idle word that we speak, we shall give account, and we must give account in the day of judgment. Thus, we must close all doors against the adversary of our souls. Let your day be entered upon with prayer, praise, and studying of the word." Testimonies for the Church, paraphrased. In closing, let us feast at the table of the Lord every morning so that we can continue to bear the fruit of the Holy Spirit. God will help us. He promises to be there in Psalm 23. He will guard our minds, our thoughts and actions as we trod into the unknown. Let Christ be our guide, our friend, our desire. Amen.
Okay, everybody, good afternoon. We're going to have our closing hymn now. And the hymn is Rejoice Ye Pure in Heart, song number 27.
Rejoice Ye.